2012, when we realized our one-year-old son, Firoz, wasn't just a boy who would speak late, but was in fact autistic, our world came crashing down around us. But belief in the Almighty and our son's gorgeous smile got us back on our feet within a few days, and so began our journey. On this journey, we put Firoz first. Whether it was me leaving my home and shifting to another country for early intervention, or his father putting his dreams on hold and only coming to see us on weekends, we knew Firoz came first. Being educated and aware is not key. What's important is acceptance. Accepting that your child is autistic and that it's a part of him, an integral, inseparable part. We were lucky to meet some amazing therapists who got Firoz speaking within a few weeks, but the journey had just begun. Trying to get onto the bandwagon, we enrolled him into a mainstream school because that was the done thing. IEPs or individual education plans were made, and he started reading and writing. In that euphoria of seeing him pick things up so fast, no one realized that these IEPs consistently ignored any social or behavioral aspects, and the most basic building blocks got left out. Focus on academics was so intense, and the urge to complete syllabus at peer level so great that he started disliking basic things like holding a pencil or picking up a book. While mainstream schools do have the intention to accommodate and include children of different needs, they may lack the infrastructure and the skill set required. What is missing are therapists and support staff who would work day in and day out with these children in order to make their lives more comfortable and functional. The harm that sensory overload may cause to an already overwhelmed child sitting in a class of 24 chatterboxes cannot be overemphasized. From my own experience, I know that all parents to differently abled children have very pressing concerns and questions in their minds. But the most important ones of these are, what did my child do at school today? How can I find out? Was anyone mean to my child? How did he react? What will happen when I am no more? Not everyone can understand this. Is the school maximizing on his true potential? No surprises here. I too was fraught with these uncertainties and scared for my child's future and well-being. Being a lawyer, many parents had reached out to me over the years with abuses suffered by their children, either in mainstream schools or special needs centers, and then they would not know what to do or where to go. Shifting schools, countries, approaches, I realized that the only way to handle all this was to take matters into my own hands and address the issues head on. And this is what led to the birth of Lahore Autism Center, where our vision and mission is to provide an integrated therapeutic and academic program tailored to each child's individual challenges and strengths. The focus is on transparency, life skills, functionality, and above all, happiness. Allowing parents to have access to therapy sessions, letting them sit and view live CCTV footage, accepting their criticism, whether constructive or otherwise, and preparing their children for a life as independent as possible are just a few basic rights every parent deserves. On this journey, I also became more educated and aware and realized that autism, like all other phenomena, comes with its realities and misconceptions. Many parents of differently abled children reached out to me over the years, and I tried to help them as much as is possible for me. However, something that I did not appreciate was the insensitivity with which some of them approached me. So let's be a little bit more sensitive, more careful. An autistic person is not a patient. They are not to be treated. We should be very open about their autism, because the more open we are, the more pride our children we know that we take in them, and the more the therapy and the therapy they deserve will reach them. An autistic child does not grow out of autism. An autistic child grows up to be an autistic adult and requires the same amount of empathy and even more respect. Let's talk about their autism as much as we talk about anything else, because talking about it will lead to acceptance. Don't expect an autie to behave like a typically developing peer when they are upset. They do shut down and they don't want to talk. And that is nothing so out of the ordinary. Don't stare. Sometimes being aloof is appreciated. Nonverbal does not necessarily mean incapable. Don't label individuals as high, moderate, or low functioning. After all, it's a spectrum and not a gradient. Their level of intelligence and skill set may not conform to society's standards of functional and normal. Talk to your typically developing children about differently abled children in a positive light, not with pity, not with disdain, and not with a smirk. And please include them. At the end, I would like to leave you with a poem that I wrote. Ye sab shehzade shehzadiyan, maa ke dil ki thandak, baap ki kamzori. Kehte hain inko takleef hai koi, theek nahi hai ye. Sach jante nahi ye log, ke theek to sirf ye hain. Duniya ko jannat banane wale, dilon ko narm aur aankh ko nam karne wale. Jinki har choti kamyabi Himalaya ko fateh dene barabar, jinka har kadam hazaron meelon barabar, jinka har lafz meethi churi ki tarah, jinki har muskurahat karodon gulabon barabar. Ye sab shehzade shehzadiyan. Thank you very much.